freedom comes from within. You have to feel that you're free. The horses are representative of that. Saving them saves all of us. In 1971, the government created the American Wild Horse and Burro Act. And it says that horses are an integral component to the natural system and that they should roam free on the public rangelands. Rewilding America Now is focused on saving wild horses. Rewilding is the solution.
Rewilding is an effort to restore ecological relationships among the diversity of native species in the region.
There are some species in nature that provides opportunities for thousands of others, and that's what we call keystone species, and the horse is definitely one of them.
Our entire history is connected to those horses. They're our compatriots from the beginning of time. But the horses are caught in the crossfire of a land grab. There are wonderful resources in our lands. Special interest groups like the cattle lobby get the mainstay of the leases because it's business. So they come in and take the horses out. The government is chasing them down with helicopters, driving them into holding facilities, chasing these horses to death with babies trying to catch up. The land mandated for the horses is now 50% less than it was in 1971.
Here's the problem with that. Not only do you lose the diversity of native species, but the bacteria and viruses in the soils that are very important for plant growth and life have all been changed. This is not a functioning ecosystem in the way we'd like to see it.
The truth is, without the diversity of all living beings, we won't survive.
We're in a place they call Sand Creek in North Dakota. My family purchased this property 20, 25 years ago. This is cattle country, and we're ridiculed because we have horses here. Everybody has this thing where they think horses are detrimental. All I have to tell you is, I think you need to look at my place.
This sunflower crop that I'll take to market wouldn't grow like this without the horses.
Horses are good for the soil. I think this is living proof that there can be a balance.
Having horses restore grasslands works very simply. They eat a great deal of grass. As they pass out their waste, you get preservation of things like seeds. Why is that important? Because that's the new generation.
The transition from monocultural intensive farming to more natural grazing systems could be a solution for a lot of climate challenges in the United States.
Fossil fuels exhale an enormous amount of greenhouse gases into the atmosphere, where they contribute to warming the planet. Rewilding captures some of these greenhouse gases in the roots of plant life, keeping carbon in the ground to the benefit of all of us.
The big thing about owning property is if you don't take care of it right, I don't feel you deserve it. Can't put a price on it. Sorry, it's an emotional thing for me, but this is the love of my life. I hope my kids and my grandkids can carry on what my dad started and be involved with horses for generations to come.
I got in contact with people here in the United States to share my experiences with rewilding in Europe. This all started in the 80s in the Netherlands because there was not much left of nature in the Netherlands. We found many nature-based solutions to create a very diverse landscape based on all the benefits that rewilding provides.
Wild horses help us grow grass, just like the buffalo. They can help to build biodiversity, bring other animals back. I'm not saying we shouldn't have cattle. We just need to have balance.
In Lakota culture, the buffalo and the horses are part of us. This is the first time in history that this land has ever had wild horses. Even though we have a colonized, heavily regulated Bureau of Indian Affairs, we still can make use of our own tribal land to raise buffalo, take care of horses. Not very many people can do that, so that's unique. Our people were true conservationists. They understood the land, the weather. We have special horses trained for buffalo hunting. How many people can do that today? That's lost. That was our survival. Or keystone with our own culture and who we are.
Rewilding is really just the traditional ecological knowledge and the understanding that native cultures have.
We have land on a reservation Roosevelt Sioux tribe. We have water, we have prairie, that's grass in my language. And if we can offer that, man, we can alleviate some pain from what the horses go through. We can give them comfort. We can give them a home.
I'm decolonizing myself to raise buffalo and bring back wild horses. And I don't bow down to nobody. I'm born and raised here like my ancestors. I'm doing what I love doing, and I'm not gonna quit.
We rescued horses from the Wheaton Holding Facility in Wyoming. And one of them had been in captivity for 9 years, never known what it would be like to be free and eat grass. I was very emotional. They were going to be free.
They've kind of lived and went to heaven instead of dying and going to heaven.
My brother performed a ceremony. He danced and showed us the heart of the horse. When you see them going up the hill, if you hear them snorting, that's the song that they're carrying with them. What do? They dance.
When I'm out here alone, when I walk through the herds, it's amazing what you can gain from that friendship with that horse, that bond with that horse, from that peace and tranquility within that horse.
Here at Rewilding America Now, we are doing something that has never been done before in the United States. We are truly bringing wild nature back through our rewilding initiatives here in Birch Creek, Idaho. On 400,000 acres of pristine lands, horses and other keystone species can run wild and coexist in peace. It will also create a much-needed wildlife corridor to Yellowstone National Park, allowing all animals to continue their migratory patterns as they transform the environment. Capturing carbon, building biodiversity, and bringing nature back to an original state of being. Join us in the movement to rewild and be a part of the future, be a part of the journey. We are people saving horses saving humanity.